Hey everybody, Jeremy Weiss here with Weiss Tech Hockey, and this is actually going to be a little bit of a different video for me today. I'm on a bit of a soapbox right now, I got to be honest with you. I was watching the playoff game between the Senators and the Canadians last night, and of course we had the big hit, Gryba on Eller. And the social media, obviously, everybody's just kind of going nuts over it, and I'm hearing so many different things, and it's actually driving me a little bit crazy. So I wanted to analyze and dissect exactly what's going on in this hit. And like I said, I'm on a soapbox here, so I'm sure there will be plenty of people who disagree with me. That's fine. Feel free to leave your comments in the comment section below. But listen, here's the deal. So we're gonna go through. I pulled the best footage I could. I went around the net. Found the best footage I could. This is actually from TSN.ca, and this is actually from an analysis that they were doing on the same hit. So there's two things you're hearing on this. First and foremost, you're hearing a dirty hit by Gryba. The second thing you're hearing is that it was Diaz's fault for making a suicide pass. So I want to address both of those points, and we'll kind of go from there. So we're going to start with whether or not it was a dirty hit by Gryba. So as you can see, there was a pass up from Diaz, arguably a suicide pass. I mean, this probably does fit the description of a suicide pass. So the pass comes up, and we're just going to kind of go ahead and hit play here. And you can see Gryba has pretty much got him lined up as soon as he touches the puck. Okay, so, and this is TSN's outlook on it, but he obviously has the puck, so it wasn't interference, which was what the call on the ice was. Okay, and the body's lined up, so it was a body-on-body check. These were the couple of things that I was looking for, and TSN's explanation of it happened to fit my, kind of my critique on it. The other thing that I checked for, and again, TSN kind of did the same thing, was whether his feet left the ground. And so you can see his feet stayed on the ice the entire time. The initial contact point is shoulder to chest, and you can see that very clearly there. Now, Eller's head does happen to bounce off kind of the back of his shoulder pad there, but the initial contact point, it's hip and shoulder on kind of the groin area and the chest of Eller. And then what does the major damage there is Eller's head bounces off the ice. So we're going to give you kind of another look here. Okay, there's the hit, and that's what it looks like. Okay, let's go again. We've got a few different angles here. Okay, so I'm gonna hit pause now. What I'm looking at this is, first of all, we kind of went through the mechanics of the hit. The hit was shoulder to chest. Now, if Eller's gonna be cutting through the middle with his head down, and his head happens to bounce off the guy's shoulder pad, I mean, the head was definitely not targeted by Gryba, in my opinion, and I think that's pretty clear from looking at the video. So as far as dirty hit, didn't leave the ice, didn't target the head. It was the contact point was the chest, so it was shoulder to chest. And what happened afterwards was Eller happened to bounce his face off the ice. Now, I'm not gonna go ahead and try to be a jerk about it, because I feel bad. I don't like to see players getting injured. But the fact of the matter is Eller was cutting through the middle with his head down and happened to get caught in a tough situation. It was a clean hit, but the way Eller, the way that the hit played out, Eller ended up, getting hit and then his face bounced off the ice. And I'm pretty convinced that that's what did most of the damage there is, when his face hit the ice. Now, so there's a level of personal responsibility, I guess, that I'm trying to figure out. Like, everybody wants to blame everybody except Eller who got hit. You know, the next thing people are saying is, well, Diaz ought to be punched in the face because he fed that suicide pass. Yeah, was it a suicide pass? Yeah, probably. Did Eller have to take it? No. Eller should have known that he was cutting through the middle, open ice, cutting through the middle with his head down, kind of looking back at the puck. That's a situation where, as an advanced hockey player like he is, he had to say, this is going to be a suicide pass. I'm getting my head up and protecting myself. You got to understand the situations. And this is kind of this specific instance, but I'm feeling like this is kind of why I'm on a soapbox. I'm feeling like this is starting to become part of a bigger picture, where we've got people, everybody wants to blame everybody else for all these problems, but really what it comes down to is every single player's individual responsibility is for his own physical well-being on the ice, right? I mean, why is it Diaz's job to make sure that Eller's got his head up? It's not. You know, if Eller looks like he's open to Diaz and Diaz happens to... was it a suicide pass? Yeah, it was. Did Eller have to take it? No, he didn't. You know, right there you can see very clearly Eller's head's looking down and slightly back trying to pick up that puck. And, you know, so that's that part. Now, we've got a bigger issue in the NHL and bigger issue in hockey in general going on with the, you know, the so-called concussion issue. Now, I'm not a doctor. I'm not even going to dive into whether or not that's a valid issue or not, or whether, you know, I'm that's not even my realm to the least. I do think that if we can avoid concussions, that's great. But I don't think it needs to be the hitter's job to make sure. I mean, there is to an extent, I guess you could say. You know, if we're going around elbows high targeting heads, I don't agree with that. But again, it comes back to personal responsibility. It's the responsibility of the receiver to make sure that he's not putting himself in a vulnerable situation where he can be hit or where he can be, you know, hit hard, knocked out. So the bigger issue of concussions that I'm, you know, that I'm noticing is, you know, I mean, people are asking, well, why is it happening? Why are there so many more concussions now? And I don't know. I don't know if there are more concussions now or if we're just more aware of it and so they're being diagnosed more often. Like I said, I'm not a doctor. That's not really my realm. What I do know is the game has changed, okay? So it's changed on a number of different levels. The science of the stride has changed. So players are better skaters now. You know, you take a look at footage, you know, from, let's just say, you know, from the 80s, 70s. The further back you go, the more rudimentary it looks. It's a lot more advanced now. The players are better skaters, they're better, they're faster, right? They're also bigger. So you've got a bigger, faster, better game going on, and we haven't changed the size of the ice that we're skating on. So we've got still playing on the same size NHL rinks. So that's, you know, that's one issue. I would love to see the game go to an Olympic size. On top of that, we've sped up the game. So, you know, if you remember, probably, what was it, back in, I think, 07-ish, 06, 07, when they started cracking down on the clutch and grab, they got rid of the red line, right? So we've tried to speed up the game. At the same time that we've been working on speeding up the game, what have we also done? We've been trying to crack down a little bit on fighting, right? So we're trying to take away some of the stuff that self-regulates the game, while at the same time opening the game, you know, for more speed. So not only are the players better skaters now, but they're also not being hauled down. I remember when I was playing juniors, right, kind of in the height of the clutch and grab era, and I remember that, man, if you got a break, man, you were pulling two or three guys with you because they were hooking, holding, clutching and grabbing. I mean, that was just the way it was. And so eliminating that, and I'm okay with eliminating that. I like the faster game, but what that's done is it's taken where you've already got better skaters anyways, and now it's adding, it's kind of opening them up so they can skate even faster, have more open ice. And so anyways, what that kind of has done, it's almost created this mentality of almost like a babysitting mentality. I mean, where it's never going to be, you know, it's not your job to look out for your own physical well-being. It's the job of the refs. It's the job of the NHLPA. It's the job of the the player making the hit to make sure that he gives a good safe hit. Well, I'm sorry, man. If you're going to cut through the middle, I mean, remember the Scott Stevens days. If you're going to cut through those trolley tracks with your head down, you knew Scott Stevens was going to absolutely light you up. And so the players aren't thinking that that's a possibility anymore. I can't go through every player's individual mindset, but that seems to be what's going on. Players are taking for granted what's actually, what the possibilities are. So you've got these guys that are cutting through the middle with their head down. Man, if you're going to cut through the middle with your head down and pretty much put your head at shoulder level with a player that's cutting through. You know, like I said, think back to the Scott Stevens days. You're going to cut through the middle with your head down and line your head up to Scott Stevens' shoulders. You know, it's your own fault if you get knocked out on the play. It really is. Now, like I said, I'm not sitting here going, you know, I love the bloodbath and I love the gladiator. It's not about that. But, you know, there has to be some responsibility on the person being hit to not put himself in a vulnerable situation, because it's the nature of the game. Now, there's a whole bunch of other tactics or issues as well. I mean, we've got the face mask issue. Now, I'm all for having the players make their own choice on that. I don't think that it should be mandated that a player needs to wear a face mask, but look at this play. He bounced his face off the ice. Would a face mask have helped him there? Yeah, but you know what? That's his own choice to make if he wants to make himself a little bit more vulnerable for the sake of, you know, possibly, you know, having a little bit better performance. Now, you know, I play men's league and I don't like wearing a face mask either. And, you know, last year I had a situation where I actually took a slap shot off the chops. And yeah, you know, did I blame the guy that shot it? No. Did I know I was putting myself in a dangerous situation? I did. And so, yeah, even though his shot shouldn't have been high, it's not his fault for shooting it high. It's my fault for not having worn the face mask. And so that's all I'm saying is, like, you know what? Let's let the players make their own decisions as far as face mask issue goes. You know, but at the same time, if you're going to make the riskier choice, then you're going to have a possibly riskier consequence. And that's just all there is to it. And so all I'm saying is, let's man up here. Let's be tough about this. And you know what? Let's, you know, at the youth levels, let's teach our kids how to give and receive hits properly, safely. It's a contact game. There are going to be instances where you get injured, but let's minimize the risk by putting the onus on the person being hit. You know, don't put yourself in a dangerous situation. Keep your head up. If you recognize a suicide pass is coming, let the pass go. Turn and look up ice so you know what's coming, you know? But as far as, you know, as far as the Gryba hit, the Eller, it's Eller put himself in a tough situation. He just did. You know, Diaz gave him a pass. It was a suicide pass. He didn't have to take the pass, but he did. And he took the pass with his head down, looking backwards in the middle of the ice, and happened to get clipped. You know, I don't think Gryba did anything wrong. I'll be interested to see what, if any, there's going to be any suspension. I hope there's not, because it was a good, clean hit, you know. But that's my 2 cents worth. That's my soapbox. I can't stand what I'm seeing as far as, you know, people blaming everybody but the person being hit. Now, if you're talking like, you know, Bure on Madonna elbow, like back in those days, yeah, that's where we can blame the guy being hit. I mean, he went out of his way to throw the high elbow in Madonna and knock them flat out. But if we're talking like a good clean hit coming through the middle, and the guy has his head down and the guy's head happens to hit the shoulder, I don't think that that's targeting. I think that that's a guy putting himself in a dumb situation. So anyways, like I said, there's going to be people who agree, people who disagree with this. I'm fine with that. Go ahead, leave your comments in the comment section below, and we can have some discussion on this. But at the end of the day, I don't think it's going to do any damage to teach our players to receive hits properly, teach them where the danger zones are on the ice, and teach them when it's acceptable, you know, to take a pass or let that pass go to avoid having, you know, a suicide pass type of situation here, you know, like we have with this Gryba hit. So that's all. That's my 2 cents worth. Thanks for listening to my soapbox.